all, it's Smme Procurement back with you in the SME clinic. And we're very, again, excited. I always seem to be excited, but I promise you we're bringing you relevant content. And this one that is quite personal to what we're seeing in our space, and that is really around the SABS standards and verification and accreditation that companies need, not just in the normal business, but as they are starting to produce things that, like sanitizers, etc. So SABS, who is also a partner of Smme Procurement, we've invited them to join us today. Dumisani, it's a pleasure to have you with us, and Ngadi, business development from SABS. And I'm pretty sure they're going to share how they are navigating all the normal process in the current regime, but I also around fast tracking certain approvals. You know, the meetings must still have to meet a certain criteria, otherwise they're not safe enough for consumption. Dumisani, thank you for joining us. I've kind of set the tone there, but just opening the discussion to you. In this environment, contact SABS, what are the options available for them? Please, enlighten us.
Okay. Thank you very much, Tevi. We as the SABS are currently working with small businesses. There's a whole lot of inquiries that are coming in at our offices or to us as individuals, where SMMEs would like to know how do they go about testing their sanitizers. And others are also interested in being certified as entities. Now, there are a few dynamics with SMMEs. One of the dynamics is the fact that SMMEs are producing their products from home, which makes it difficult for them to be certified. What we then encourage them is to test their products against the necessary standards. Now, this is one way we're trying to assist SMMEs. And then the second way is to ensure that we first check their certification process. Their certification process would involve auditors going in to verify whether there are processes in place and whether those SMMEs comply to the relevant quality management standards. And that would also include the sampling of sanitizers. As SABS, we are working on regimes of reducing the time spent testing the products. The authorization of the process will soon be announced, and SMMEs will be informed about those processes that will be involved going forward in ensuring that we fast track this process and those sanitizers are out there in the market. But we are not only looking at sanitizers, other SMMEs are also focusing on the production of face masks. And those as well, they need to be tested to verify whether they adhere to the required standards. Again, we are pulling in strategic partners who will assist us in ensuring that those face masks are tested within a short space of time so that those face masks can be readily available in the market. Those are some of the interactions that we have. But over and above that, there are other challenges, David, that SMMEs are experiencing. They would say, yes, we've got a product, but we do not have the funds to pay for the testing. That's where we link SMMEs with our strategic partners. One of the key strategic partners that we have is SEDA, which is Small Enterprise Development Agency. We work very closely with them. We then refer SMMEs to SEDA, and SEDA will then process their application. Upon the approval of the application, we'll then take those particular samples, test them, see that we pay a portion. And if there's anything to go by, the SMME will pay a fraction, and SABS as well contributes a minimum of 20% towards the testing fees.
Dumisani, what kind of fees are we talking? Is it 500 Rand, 50,000 Rand? That an SME would look to spend for verification or accreditation?
I wouldn't want to thumbsuck, but it's anything between 15,000 and about 50,000. Okay. It depends on the number of products the client is bringing for testing. Okay. But then you'll find that many a times, those products that are being tested are within the threshold that is defined by CEDA, and CEDA takes care of those particular fees. But when it comes to certification, it therefore becomes a different ballgame altogether, purely because now we are quoting you for the pre-assessment fees as well as the annual audit fees. And those annual audit fees will be factored over a period of 3 years, but the pre-assessment fees will be then factored for that particular period when you're being audited.
Okay, that I think that gives clarity. And what I know how long is a piece of string, but let's take the sanitizer example. What is a standard timeline for the audit process versus what you're targeting to?
Perhaps let's look at the testing first.
Okay.
Testing involves two segments. It involves the microbiology testing as well as the stability test. Now, when you look at the two, it will take you about 6 months because the stability test takes about 6 months. Now, what we are doing is we are saying, let's reduce the number of days for testing sanitizers. We are currently looking at 22 days. And that is why I alluded to the fact that initially that we are looking at reducing the number of days. As soon as we get that approval, the maximum number of days for testing sanitizers will be 22 days. That's what we are looking at. Which
will
be the
best.
Yes. But with regards to certification, we are working with a team that will be readily available to go out there and audit clients, and they will be able to come back and say there is a system in place. The client either complies or doesn't comply. So those are some of the basic essentials that we are looking at involving going forward.
Excuse my ignorance, Dumisani. I know it would be different per product, but if someone wanted to ensure that everything was in place and they did comply before they actually applied to SABS, is there a checklist? Is there some sort of guideline that they would work to?
Yes, there is a checklist or there are guidelines. The guidelines are in line with the various standards for each and every product that there is out there.
Where would they access this if for the man on the street?
Right now, we are working with the International Standards Organization, which is known as ISO.
ISO, yeah.
They have availed standards for free, and SMMEs can be able to access those standards by just going through the www.iso.org. They will be able to access those particular standards. And those standards, if you look at the list that has been availed, which has got more than 10 standards, they are all about the basic products that are needed right now.
Fantastic. That's very encouraging. And guys, I hope you heard that. So www.iso.com?
.org.
.org. Okay. So .org, but it's the ISO, the International Standards Organization, has availed those standards that are, I suppose, essential products or services at the moment. So go and have a look at that. Now, the next step is I want to contact SABS. Where do I go from here, Dumisani, if I now want to start the process with my product?
They can contact me directly, Debbie. And my contact details are as follows. It's 072-267-7955, or else they can contact me through my email, which is Dumisani, as in Dumisani, .mngadi, which is my surname, Perhaps I need to spell it.
I think so.
M for Mike, N for November, G for Golf, A for Alpha, D for Delta, I for India, dumisani.mngadi@sabs.co.za.
Fantastic. And guys, we will put it again in the description below and share that with our audience. Dumisani, you know, we focused a lot on shortening the time, the verification process in the context of COVID-19. As I said, we've seen a lot of small businesses wanting to link to big business and they want to work with each other, but those standards are very important. And I'm very, very encouraged to hear that between CEDA, yourselves and other partners, you're helping to fast track that. In terms of more long-term view, is there anything else that you would like to share, keeping in mind that our audience is also procurement? Anything in terms of SABS's long-term approach to standards in South Africa?
What we are doing in the long term, we are partnering with various government entities, particularly the departments of economic development in various provinces. And we are partnering with these entities just to ensure that SMMEs have got access to SABS and they can be able to access their our services as an entity. But over and above that, these partnerships are also ensuring that we provide a cushion to SMMEs. Rather than paying exorbitant fees, somebody meets them halfway through. And that's what these strategic partners are doing. And that's their great importance from various provinces. As I can tell you right now, we're working with various departments of economic development. Their key focus is developing SMMEs that are producing detergents. And we are trying to make sure that those SMMEs that are producing detergents do not fail if they bring their products for testing. And what we have identified, that is why we're coming up with this long-term goal, is that most of the products that are being brought by SMMEs to our laboratories, they do fail, and they fail in areas such as the labeling, the packaging, and the branding of the product. You'd realize that most of these products do not adhere to the various standards. That is why we then said, let's come up with a drive of ensuring that we create the strategic partners that are going to focus on SMMEs that are producing detergents.
So Dumisani, if I hear what you're saying, is that it's not that the product is a substandard product, it's just the way they label and match the bottling, for instance, which is something that can be overcome.
It can be either one of the two,
okay.
But most of the time you'll find that the product passes, but the labeling, the marking, that's what we call it in our language, the markings are the ones that are failing, purely because they are not in line with the standards. Now, if we create the strategic partners, the strategic partners will then get some subscription from SABS. They will subscribe with SABS, where they have access to these particular standards. It makes it easier for SMMEs to access those standards through our partners, and then they will be able to go through those and know what is required. If I'm to label a, for example, a dishwashing liquid, how am I going to label it? Because now I have got this particular standard through a funder or through a strategic partner.
Fantastic. And I think there's also a great opportunity, which is what we've had in discussions with SABS around the corporate partnership, ED programs, supply development programs, to come to the party now as well around funding those standards. So it sounds like it's anyone who has the appetite, you will lead them to potential funders. If relevant, like CEDA, perhaps we can also suggest to SMEs, reach out to your current clients and see if they are prepared to assist you to grow. But we definitely appreciate the fact that it's not a white elephant. It is doable. It's very important. And it definitely is the right move for SMEs to look at not just producing locally, but, you know, take post-COVID-19 and post-lockdown, that they can look to be exporting. I mean, it's an international standard, so it would never be a wasted exercise to make sure that you are compliant as a small business. And big business will definitely, I think, look
most at... Most definitely, Debbie.
Thank you so much, Dumisani. I appreciate it. Thank you for what you're doing. I know your staff are out there as well in this time, almost as frontline workers, making sure that this process is happening. And we know it's very important, and it's very important to support small business. So to our SMEs, stay strong. To our procurement audience, I hope this was also valuable for you, and very happy to link you to Dumisani below. Dumisani, thank you. We look forward
thank
to
you very much,
supporting the necessary within South Africa. Stay safe.
Thank you very much.